My name is Cesar Pascual. I work at the Luxembourg Institute of Science and Technology, and my objective is to develop the next generation of sensors for health. Sensors are devices that can detect many things, like for example, in a camera can detect light. For us, sensors can detect molecules. And the interest is to detect molecules that are in your blood, for example, that can sense a disease or can give a warning about something that is going wrong. So this prototype is made of different parts. The first one, it's a chip, which is a piece of silicon. And on top of this piece of silicon, we start to put the different components, layer by layer. What we do is that we use photolithography. Photolithography, it's using ultraviolet light to impress the design that we have made into a resist, which is photosensitive. After UV lithography, we bring our sample to the evaporator, where we evaporate around 20 nanometers of gold, which is a very thin layer, only few atoms high, and then we take the sample out, and then we do liftoff. The areas that have been patterned, the gold will stay. The areas that have not been patterned, the gold will go off, so we will have the electrodes. So you can deposit these films, and then you need to also write on these fields in order to create your cells. And to write in these cells, the tool that can give you the maximum resolution is the electron microscope. Electron microscope is used to visualize pictures which you cannot see on a normal optical microscope, but at the same time you can use these electrons to write into a resist which is also electron sensitive. This is very useful for us because, for example, we can deposit on our devices things which are called nanowires, which are very sensitive sensors and very small sensors. The process of sensing begins with the creation of a beam recognition part in which you have to put the molecules which are selective to the analytes that you want to detect on your sensor. And if your sensor is complex, then you don't have to put one, but you have to put many of them. The second thing that you have to do, then you run your sample. And then when you run your sample on some places where you have put the right information, the analyte that you want to detect, if it's there, will bind there. It's like a lab on a chip. Electrochemical sensors allow you the same control that you would have with a computer. So the same that a computer can control millions of transistors, electrochemical sensors can be parallelized in a way that you can sense at the same time millions of molecules. The aim is to pass from a device that is making something very interesting to an application that can go into the hospitals.